Ultispice particularly. As I told you in the earlier video, there are many software tools which you can use for VLSI design simulations. It could be a digital simulation or it could be an analog simulation. So you have already used Cadence. This is your Cadence website, cadence.com, wherein you will find everything related to the Cadence, all kinds of softwares, etc., etc. And this already you have done. This is a commercial toolset. Now you have a problem that you cannot use this toolset because you are sitting at home. There is another toolset that is given by Synopsys. Synopsys is also a commercial toolset. It is having ASPICE as a simulator tool. If you get ASPICE evaluation version, then you can in fact use ASPICE also. So it is up to you. If you want, you use ASPICE simulator. Then there is another software or another company that works in EDA domain that is called as Mentor Graphics. So Mentor Graphics is having again many tool sets. So in Mentor Graphics, you have Eldo simulators for this IC design. So you can, if you get the evaluation tool set from Mentor Graphics, if you are able to download, then I would recommend this as another tool set which you can use. So I am showing you various tool sets from the companies so that if you have an access to any of them, then it doesn't matter what kind of tool set actually you are using, your theoretical background needs to be very strong. So in fact, all these tool sets, they work in two ways. Either you can enter your code in SPICE language, so I will show you a few examples how can you write the SPICE code, or you can simply drag and drop various devices and create a schematic out of it. So therefore, once you have an access to toolset, then you can work on it. Then there is another company that also gives you various toolsets like Tanner. So Tanner are having many products like schematic edit, T-edit or T-spice or schematic spice, Tanner S-edit. So this toolset, if it is available to you, like Tanner S-Edit toolset is available to you, then you can use Tanner. However, remember this Cadence or Synopsys or its Mentor Graphics toolsets, these are all commercial toolsets. Then there is one more IC layout and IC circuit design toolset, and it's a very good toolset. In fact, its evaluation versions will be available online. You can try to install them and download. So there is a website, staticfreesoft.com, and there is a manual also given. You can see the kind of front page you get for the layout simulation over here. So you can download complete electric toolset. So this is the website from where you can get the electric toolset. Electric is also one of the sophisticated CAD toolset. Then there is one more tool that is called as MSPICE. So simply come to MSPICE here, download the software. So once you download the software, it's very easy to simulate the toolset. I have a lot of codes available with the MSPICE, but however, now my Windows system has been changed. So there is some error that is happening, so I'm not able to install. Otherwise, I would have shown you the various simulation examples in MSPICE. But it is a very simple tool to use. If you can download and install on your PC, then you can use even MSPICE software. Then there's an NGSPICE. This is an NGSPICE software. So you can download NGSPICE, particularly if your PC is a Linux based system, then this will be very good. So download the NGSPICE, and it's a completely open source SPICE simulator. So you need not purchase anything. And there are many models, MOSFET models that are supported. So this is the website, note it down, that on this website you will get download files, examples, documentation, etc. So you can work even on NGSPICE. Then there is another software, and this is what I am going to use, and I hope many of you probably are going to use the same software, that is from Analog Devices. Analog Devices is a very popular multinational company that works in the VLSI domain, and they provide you a free tool set that is called as an LTSpice, Linear Technology Spice. So this is the website. You come to this website. On this website, here there is a download LTSpice. So you download LTSpice either for Windows 7, 8 or 10, and you will also get the installation documentation over here. So entire LTSpice getting started PDF you will find on this website. So this is a license agreement. Let us accept this license agreement. So this is what it exactly is, the LTSpice starting guide. So download this guide and keep it in your folder for the quick reference and how exactly you are going to use LTSpice for the simulation. If you have any issues, you can actually go through this LTSpice guidelines. So once you download and install, then I will show you how to use it exactly. However, here also on this website, there are many examples that are being shown, many examples given. You can go through the various simulation models. You can go through various examples. You can download them and you can work around it. So these are all simulation models that are available on this website. If you go to education block, then you will also get blocks, etc., so on and so forth. So now our point of discussion will be actually LTSpice. Let me show you when you install what exactly happens, where it gets installed. So this is the icon you will get, LTSpice XV11. This is the particular version that is available now. Now there are two ways to run your code in LTSpice. So one is schematic, which I will show you first, and then you can also write the Spice code. So this is a PDF file which I have prepared for your reference if you are writing LTSpice in as a Spice language, if you are entering your code into the Spice language. Now let us open, double click on that icon. So this is what you will get. Now let us try to write the new schematic. So click over here, you get this screen. Now I'll try to simulate a simple CMOS inverter first. So there are many pick and place elements over here. So I click on the component. I'll get components, many components here. You can see that ADCs, comparators, DACs, op amps, so on and so forth. Many components are available. So let me pick up PMOS device. Shall I pick up PMOS? Yes. So there is a 3 terminal PMOS available and there is a 4 terminal PMOS available. So I can pick up anything out of this. Let me pick up 4 terminal PMOS. Okay. So once I click that, I'll get 4 terminal PMOS over here. I'll put it on the screen. Just click, it will be put on the screen. If I move my cursor, then it will show me another PMOS. If I click, it will put another PMOS. So I don't want right now. So I simply press an escape key. Now what I want is NMOS device. So I'll go to NMOS. NMOS also 3 terminal as well as 4 terminal device is available with me. Let me pick 4 terminal device. So this is my NMOS, correct? So from where I have picked up, from these components I have picked up, correct? Now I need a DC source, VDD, to be connected. So I pick up a DC source, voltage source. So there is a voltage here. Click on the voltage and I'll get the voltage source. So I pick up and click the voltage source. Okay. Similarly, I need a voltage source for giving the inputs. So I'll pick and place voltage source here also and I press escape. Now I need to do connections. So there is a wire available with me. Click here and then do connections properly. So click on one node and click on the second node and double click it. That's it. This is how the connection happens. Then escape. So this is how the connection happens. So how I am connecting, just see carefully. I am connecting here. Click on wire. let us say I want to connect this node to V1, so I click here, then I click wherever I want to go. Sorry, it has not clicked. So I'll click over here. What is happening? Let me click the wire. Yes, it has got clicked. So this is how I got connected V1 to this PMOS. Now I want this connection, that is bulk should be connected, bulk for PMOS should be connected to the voltage source, right? Similarly, I want bulk of NMOS to be connected to the ground, right? Actually connection to the ground. Now I have to place the ground also. This is the ground that is available. I can directly place it here. I want the ground over here, and I want the ground to be connected over here. So there are three places where I need to connect ground. Now I am going to connect the ground to all these three places. So here this is the ground connection. Then this is the another ground connection. Just click here on wire, then click at the node which you want to connect, then press mouse key and click at the other node. See, it is not connected, it shows like this. I want it to be at the center. This is how you can zoom. You can zoom in, zoom out, those things you can do if you want. You can make it full screen by clicking here and then go on pressing escape. Whenever there is an issue, you simply press escape key. So from here, now this is a very dedicated connections. You have to patiently connect all these wires. Now this wire, now I need to short both the inputs, because same input I am going to apply to both the terminals, right? That is both the gates of the NMOS device. Now I can in fact connect here, sir, some capacitance and so at output, but let us wait for on that. Now I need to set the properties of sources, correct? So here I right click on this source and I apply some voltage. Let us say I apply 2.4 volts, correct? Okay. So V1 is applied as 2.4 volts. Now I need to apply V2. So V2, I go to advanced. Now I can apply whatever I need out of this. Let me say I click on the pulse voltage. So initial value of the pulse voltage should be, let us say, 0, correct? Then when it is on, it should be VDD, so it is 2.54 volts, correct? Now this is asking about T delays. Let me specify 1 nanosecond initial delay, rise time also 1 nanosecond, fall time also 1 nanosecond, and on time. So on time, let me specify, let us say 10 nanoseconds, and then period, total period, I would like to specify 30 nanoseconds rather than having even and odd, let us say, or same on time, let us say 30 nanoseconds. And number of cycles to be run, let us assume 10 cycles be run, and then okay. See how the statement is added. Remember that such kind of statements should be visible on your screen. You can set the font size, etc. for this statement so that other things are visible. Now, if you want to set the properties of NMOS and PMOS, you can set here. So, like you can make right click and then length, etc. you can set similarly for other device. So, NMOS and PMOS both. Now, let us keep it bare minimum at this point of time like this and let us try to simulate this circuit. So, here there is a running man on the upper strip, you can see here. So, click this, it will run your circuit. Now, transient analysis it is asking. So, when you want to stop this simulation, so we have given actually 10 cycles and I think time period mentioned was 30 and 20. So, let us assume we want to 200 nanoseconds, something like that. Let us set 200 nanoseconds. Correct. Transient time 200 nanoseconds. Time to start saving the data is 1 nanoseconds. From 1 nanoseconds you start. Correct. Maximum time step. Again, 1 nanosecond should be the time step. Right. And OK. So, as soon as I click that, I got the here something called as a result pane. Now, whatever I want to see in this result pane, I should click that particular node. Now, when you come to circuit, just see how my cursor changes at the node. So, if I click here now, waveform should be added, which is applied to gates of the two MOSFETs. So, I click here, see how this is the waveform is added. Now, wherever I want to see the other waveform, I should click that. If I click here, I should get the output waveform, see the output waveform. So, both input and output waveforms I got. Now, let us say I want to see it properly in different up and down manner. Then right click and add a plot pane. Add plot pane is there. If you want to only see the simulation results, you simply click over here. So, this plot pane is added. Now, I can shift my input and output. Correct? So, just click over here and shift it. So, this is what is my input and output for the inverter. Now, I can zoom this and to see any particular portion. For example, I want to zoom this and I can see and study the actually propagation delay, etc. All those studies I can do. Okay. I can add, if any input is interested, I can select from here. That means I need to click here and select the input. I can do auto ranging, etc. Now I come to plot settings. If I want to save this particular plot, there are many settings available over here. I can reset the colors, I can mark the data points. If I click, see it is marking all the data points, right? All these things I can do. I can do manual limits, setting of the manual limits on the axis. I can name the axis, all those things are possible, right? And you can save this particular plot. So when you save this plot, it will be saved like .plt format. It will be .plt. For example, here plot settings or file, go to file. And you can save the plot, save plot settings as, so this, see, this is .plt, correct? So you can save the inverter in .plt format and you can open it afterwards. So this is how you can do the simulation. Now let us, this is a transient simulation, correct? It is with respect to time. This is a transient simulation. Let us say I would like to go for a DC simulation for the same circuit, correct? So now right click this waveform and now I would like to go for it, not for this pulse simulation, but I want to go for a DC simulation. So that also I can do, that is possible to do over here, right. So that means I don't want to apply transient waveform, correct? So now let us apply some DC value of 2.4 volts. Initial value probably would be 0. Let us say it says OK. And I run the simulation. Oh, sorry, it is not like this. DC command should be added there. So there is still transient command is there. I need to remove my transient simulation command. From where I should be doing that? Let me see. End simulation command. So it was already running the earlier simulation. Sorry, I need to stop that simulation here. So now basically, see from where I have gone here, simulate, and end simulation command. Now it is asking me some other type of simulation whether I want to do. So let us go for this kind of simulation. My input is, I am going to sweep now the source V2 and I will do the linear sweeping, correct? So starting value should be 0, input should be 0 volts and I want the final value to be 2.4 volts and it should sweep in 0.1 volts. 0.1 volts sweeping should happen. So this is the DC command it is going to add, right? So I switch on OK. Now you can see that DC simulation it is adding. I click it on the screen. This should come, otherwise it will not do the simulation, remember. Now I run this. Now some mistakes I did actually. 2.4 volts. Yes. It is advanced 2.4 volts. Okay. So what's an error? Syntax error in .dc command. Oh, why two zeros have come? There is some issue. Sorry, name of the first source it is asking. That is wrong. It should be V2. Right? It is the name of the source. It is not 0. It is a V2. V2 is the name of the source. Now I run. And now I want to see the waveforms here. See, the input is already been there. I would like to see, let us say, output. So I click on the output node and this is what I get. If I want to see input also, this is what is the input. Correct? So I got here the characteristics, the VTC characteristics for CMOS inverter. You can see the VTC characteristics for CMOS inverter, right? So now if I want to change, let us say, length, etc., I come to this particular graph and I can change the length. I can modify the length and then I can do the simulation. Now you must be interested to know that exactly which kind of model file this is going to use. This simulator is using which model file? I would like to know that. So for that purpose, let us try to find out the SPICE code of this particular circuit. So when you come over here, view, there is a SPICE netlist. Click on the SPICE netlist. So you will get a SPICE code. This is the SPICE code. So it indicates that there are two transistors. This is M1. There is another transistor M2. And there are two voltage sources. So one is towards input side that is required, that is V2 for giving the input. And another is VDD. So that was V1 here. And two model files it is using, NMOS and PMOS. And see the path for the model file actually. The path for the model file is going to documents, LTSpice, library, CMP and standard MOS, standard.MOS. This is the file from where, this is the model file from where it is actually simulating this particular code, right? I would recommend you to go for some other methodology that is using the SPICE code, right? So I am going to share one folder with you. So let me show you that folder also. So it is available on the LTSpice website itself, that there are various models that are available on LTSpice website. You can download those model files, you can download the examples and then you can use them. So let me find out where exactly that model is. So right now the model that you have executed is something different. And when you go to website on LTSpice, you will get some other model also. So this is your default model. It was available in this particular folder. Okay, this is what is from CMOS EDU. So there is a website, I will show you that resource. It's a very good resource actually. It's a very good resource. So go to the website called as CMOS EDU. CMOSEDU.com. So on this website, there are many examples given. So if you go to this, these are the softwares, Electric, SPICE, LASSIE, LTSPICE, etc. So if I click on LTSPICE, I will get many examples, video codes, so on and so forth. There are two very popular books. One is CMOS Circuit Design Layout and Simulation, and another is CMOS Mixed Signal Circuit Design. These two books, in these two books, there are many codes, etc. are given, and they have given how to use the LTSPICE. Right? They have also given the typical LTSPICE kind of example related to LTSPICE. So this is what you should be downloading. When you download this, you will get a model file, separate model file inside this folder. So that is what I was searching. So this is that model file. This is the same folder that I have downloaded. If I open this particular model file, see what I actually get. So this is the model file. So in this model file, you will find all the desired parameters, correct? Now what I'll try to do is, I'll try to simulate the inverter example from SPICE code. So let us come to this particular setup, that is a SPICE code. So now I am interested in opening the SPICE code. So just click over here. And then the file that I was trying to show you, I'll go to the same file which was downloaded. So from CMOS EDU. So click here, netlist. You can click all files. And in all files, when you write the SPICE code, you should write it in a word pad and then save it as a filename.cir. So here let me check any .cir file is there available. Inverter simulation. Log file. Now these are not CIR files actually. Now these are all, I think, directly schematic. So let me try to open if any schematic is there. So this could be the inverter schematic. Okay, this is how he is trying to do. Let me explain this particular methodology also. I'll close my earlier simulations. I'll try to open the files from this particular example. So all my .asc file, .circuit files, I'm going to open. So this is the one, this is the second, this is the third, and this is the fourth. So all files which are given in that particular folder, I'm trying to open one by one. This is inverter.asc. Then I'll open inverter.trans. So inverter simulation underscore trans and inverter simulation. So these three files. I'll also open one more file, that is a ring oscillator. All these files I'll try to open. Now this is an inverter file, and this is your typical inverter. No connections are done for the VDD and the VIN. They are not shown, right? And you can see here at the bottom, that dot include CMOS EDU models dot text. So in this particular folder, there is a CMOS EDU models. So this model file has been included in this particular circuit. Then from this circuit, and symbol for the inverter is created. So this symbol for the inverter is exactly same as this circuit. Right, and then to this symbol we are applying input source and VDD, and we are trying to do the transient simulations. So this is the transient simulation. So there, this file shows that there is a command added for the transient simulation. Now let me run this particular inverter for transient simulation. So this is how what I get, correct? So I got here input and I got the output. You can see that this is the transient simulation. So now you can easily calculate, you can easily calculate the propagation delay for this particular inverter, right? Then in fact entire design for the ring oscillator is also available in the same folder. If you run, you should get the ring oscillator output. So if you run, see, you get the ring oscillations. These are the oscillations. So inverter, back to back connected inverter actually works as an oscillator. Odd number of inverters you will have to connect. So these are odd number of inverter back to back connected inverters in a closed loop format. So this is what is available in that folder, correct? So now you can actually, the benefit of this is you can change the characteristics of this particular device. Now if you right click, you will be able to change length and width, and you will be able to see the various characteristics. You got the point? Yes, this is what we can do. Now I'll try to open my earlier simulation which I did, because I want to show you one more thing, that is how to see the current in the circuit, how exactly to see the current in the circuit. I'll go to my earlier example of CMOS inverter, which I have not saved, I suppose, right? So it's okay. When we will do the DC simulation, that time I will show you that, because this is a transient simulation. I don't want to show it over here. Now next thing I want to show, how exactly we can write this SPICE code. So how to do the simulation using the SPICE code. That's the next purpose. So now let me open another file which I have created for you, that is using the SPICE code. So here there is in VLSI lab, let me come to inverter example. In inverters example, I have written many examples. So out of this, let us say inverter circuit, this is my document. So you write this in a word file, then store it as a .cir, remember. Okay, so this is the SPICE code. Now in SPICE code, first line is always a comment, then this is a VDD source, and then you have got the various statements in SPICE, right? So I will try to explain you how exactly this SPICE code works, so that it becomes easy for you to understand. So that I will explain you in the next video. I don't want to disturb that right now. So now let me tell you that this is an input source that is applied, and these are the two transistors, NMOS and PMOS, connected to an inverter. This is the output capacitance, and these are those two model files. In model file, I can directly mention here the threshold voltage for that particular device, and I want to do DC simulation, so .dc. I run this. So see, when I run this particular code, I got this as my output. So this is the output, and this is my code, and this is exactly, this is my output. This extra pin which is added, I want to delete. This should not have been added. Yes. Just click on delete. So this is the output for CMOS inverter. This is my inverter, right? Now let us say I want to see here the current. So how to see the current? How to see the current? So here, now current, I can say drain current I want. So ID, drain current, okay. On the same graph, this is the drain current. Now add plot plane. If I add the plot plane, now let us say I want here the signal to be added. Now here the signal added is what we want. Let us say V out. Correct. So V2 is in, and in the same graph I want V out to be added. So V out is V3. So I want V3. If I want to see them together, current and this graph, I can see this pen. I would like to delete this pen. So here you can right click if you want, and you can add the traces. This is what you can do. Whatever traces you want to add. For example, I directly wanted V3. So sorry, I wanted to add the trace. So click on Control. I want to add V3. I want to add the drain current for M1, or it could be for M2, anything. And I also want to add the input. Oh, I'm not able to select through one manner. Yeah, V3 drain current, and this is okay. It's okay. Oh my god. So again, so many signals are added. Let me delete the other signals. So I don't want this particular signal. So many times it has been added. Delete. How to delete this? How to delete this? Which one is this? I want to delete this. So here you can see that there is a drain current. There is a V in versus V out, and this is the input voltage, which is linearly varying. Now, if you want to adjust this particular scale, you can simply right click here. The top values we have given is 2.4, so let me put it as a 2.4 volts, and I want, let us say, is to start from 0 volts or 0 millivolts, whatever, 0. So I put it at 0, okay, correct? No, bottom also should have been changed. So bottom should be 0 millivolts. Sorry, this is tick, bottom should be 0 millivolts. So this is the range. That means now my output is from 0 to 2.3, and I'm able to see all the curves, and this is the input. Similarly, I can also adjust the input. Towards right hand side, there is a current. You can see that initial part of the current is 0, and then it goes on increasing. You get the maximum current over here, and then again there is a decrease in the current. Now if I simply want to see where my graph exactly shifts after changing the device ratios. So here I am going to scale. Let us say I will make P type of transistors width as 360 nanometers. Initially it was 90 nanometers. Now I will change it to 360 nanometers. In fact, I'll do it like this. I'll make NMOS as 90 nanometers, and PMOS is very, very large. Let us say 360 nanometers, and I do the simulation. Oh, sorry. 2 M1 are switched on. Oh, yeah, sorry. 2 M1s are switched on. So only one should be there. So one is M1, another is M2, correct? So that means M2 is fixed to 180, and M1 is 360, and I run this simulation. So this is what I get now, correct? This is what I get. So my graph is shifted towards right hand side. So this is how you can do for changing the width, changing the threshold voltage, etc. You can do for all these things for all the parameter changing. You can go on changing the parameters. Now if I want, let us say, transient analysis, then what is to be done? So in the same code, I will show you how to do the transient analysis. I'll simply comment my earlier code so that it becomes simple for me to explain you. So here this bottom code is the transient analysis. So this particular line Vin is for the input pulse that I am applying. Then this is my PMOS device. So here in PMOS device is first 3, that indicates that it is a drain terminal. Then next is indicates gate terminal, then source terminal, and then the bulk terminal. Okay. So next video I will exactly explain you how to write this SPICE code. So M1, M2 are PMOS and NMOS devices. C is the output capacitance. There are 2 model files, and I want transient simulation. So now I'm going to run this particular code. So this is what I get. So there is an input, and there is an output waveform on the same plot. Now I can actually calculate the propagation delay, etc. Right? So this is how you can do the inverter simulation. Let me also open one more file which I have written for you. that is this file. Let me run this file. So again, this is the simulation of an inverter. This is an inverter. You can see that this is an inverter. Okay. So it runs properly. So this inverter runs properly. This is the code for inverter, and there is a code for measuring the average power dissipation. So average power dissipation is drain current into the voltage, drain current of M1 transistor multiplied the voltage at the particular node, that is 003 at this particular node. So if I write this particular command, I will be able to measure the voltage. Now I will have to go to a log file to see the exactly the voltage, where exactly it will show me the voltage. See, it is showing here in that log file, average power comes out to be 2.69 into 10 to the power minus 8 watts. And that is calculated for this over this period of time. So this is how you can calculate the average power, right? So from where I have seen this, so this is the command that is added in the SPICE code. Now go to view and find out the SPICE log, SPICE error log. So in the log file, you will actually get this data, correct? So anything that you want in a textual form, you can get it in the log file, okay? So basically, this is the PDF file, which is a guideline I have written for you. That is, download the SPICE, whatever version available now for you, for Linear Technologies website. Write down the SPICE code in the notepad or wordpad and save it at .cir or .sp or .txt. Open the file in the LTSPICE and then you run the transient simulation or DC simulation or AC analysis, whatever you would like to do. And click on the run icon and then finally you will get the output. So this is how you can use LTSPICE for doing the simulations. So I hope I have explained you the use of LTSPICE, and then in next experiment or next video I'll try to explain you how exactly you write down the code for NAND, NOR, etc. So thank you very much.